Is someone ready to score cheap points? I'm amazed that someone in your position could take such lies seriously.
We have to check on everything.
Yes, well, I hope you're satisfied.
Thank you, Mr. Stanfield. I appreciate you're a busy man.
Anytime you wish to interview me about my party's policies, just ring my secretary for an appointment.
I'll do that. Bye.
Yes, Mr. Stanfield. Yes, at once.
Hey, you can't do that.
You're right. Sorry. Detective Sergeant Ryan.
Morning.
Morning.
Everything quiet?
Just the usual. Everything's under control.
Well, it's an improvement on last night.
Oh?
I think we'll have to keep an eye on that Carol Lewis.
Well, I don't think she's getting away with anything.
No, but she's getting some rough treatment from some of the women. Someone punched her on the way to dinner last night.
I know some of the women dislike her, so she's bound to get a few knocks every now and again. Doesn't bother me.
Well, I think it should.
Really? Oh, didn't realize it was our job to make her popular with the other women. Come on, Meg, Carol Lewis, she can well and truly look after herself.
And it's not our job to make them unpopular either.
When the women are wrangling amongst themselves, they're more easily controlled. And we're here to maintain order, which is exactly what I intend doing.
Well, I don't think it's fair. I nearly run out of biscuits and all my fruit's gone.
You can have some of mine, Dor.
Oh, thanks, but that won't last long, not with no buyer for a week. What do you reckon, Dee?
Not much we can do about it now, except share and pull our belts in a
bit. Yeah, well, I don't think we should have to.
Mr. Faulkner, you're just the man we need.
What do you want now?
Very little, really, just some information. Why is Helen Smart been put in solitary and how long is she going to be there?
We'll have to get that information from the deputy governor.
Oh, she wouldn't give us the time of day.
That's about all you get from me, too.
Well, what's the harm in telling us something we're going to find out eventually anyway?
You'll find out when she's released, so just be patient. Nothing you can do about it now, anyway.
Please, Mr. Faulkner.
Sorry. Get back to work.
Damn!
There must be some way we can help her.
Yeah, they certainly have it in for her.
If only we get past the censorship and get Helen's story to the outside where it could do some good.
Well, maybe we could smuggle a letter or something out in the laundry bags.
Hey, that's a great idea.
No, it wouldn't work. They'd check them. Besides, you'd have to rely on a stranger to pass it on.
Well, we could put lots of letters in.
Oh, well, that wouldn't work either, would it? I mean, they find one letter, they're going to keep searching till they find them all.
Why not write it on the sheets with the laundry markers?
Don't be stupid.
Well, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah. Get a point there. Couldn't write much, though.
Well, you could write Free Helen Smart.
Or ask your local member about Helen Smart's imprisonment. Once the sheets were folded and pressed, probably wouldn't be noticed.
And when the people in the old folks' homes and the hospital start asking questions, somebody's going to have an answer.
I reckon that's a damn good idea, Carol. Yeah, let's get started before the trucks arrive.
Visitor this afternoon, Judy.
Me? Who is it?
Detective Sergeant Burke. It's about Jackie's confession.
But I thought that... Well, I mean, do you think they'll take it seriously now?
Well, I hope so. Unfortunately, I called him before the assault. But don't give up.
I hope it all works for you, Judy.
Well, unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about it one way or the other.
Well, Jackie's not that bad. Well, if she tells the truth this time, it should be okay.
Thank you.
sorry I've wasted your time, but you'll have to unload the bags. There'll be no laundry going out today.
Got any more bright ideas?
Save your energy for the work. We've still got all our regular stuff to get through, as well as this lot.
Yeah, well, don't blame me. It's not my fault. It's her. She's bloody jinxed.
You're probably right.
What?
About me being jinxed.
Now, that I think you better explain.
It's not my fault Mrs. Morris found all those marked sheets.
Yeah, and you all thought it was worth trying.
And none of the other things that happened around here are my fault either.
You mean like us losing our privileges and our buyer?
I'll give it a rest, Doreen.
No, Bea. That's exactly what I mean.
All right, then. Whose fault was it?
Well, you work it out for yourself. I get done for kidnapping, and the girl's mother turns out to be the deputy governor of Wentworth. She puts me on cleaning duty. The rec room winds up looking like a bomb site. She puts me on kitchen duty. Stuff gets nicked out of the store and is found in the recreation room. So what happens? You all lose your privileges and I get the blame. You bloody work it out for yourselves.
You know, I think there might be something in what Carol said.
What do you mean?
Carol hasn't taken her eyes off her. She's been watching her like a hawk. And she didn't like Margot sitting there.
Are you sure?
Not yet. Well, I'm working on it.
Have the prisoners in solitary been fed?
Yeah, Susie Driscoll's taking their meals up after lunch.
Well, that's too late. I'll arrange for them to go now.
Gaffney, leave your meal until you've taken some food up to solitary.
Why don't you start it?
Do as you're told. You wouldn't like them to starve, would you?
It isn't fair.
Any more back chat and you can eat up there with them. Go on, get to the kitchen.
And now I'm sure.
Well, it certainly explains a few things that have been going on around here lately. What are you going to do about it?
Anyone like to sit with Bev and Lil?
What for?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I could use a change of company.
That's a good one. Hey, Carol, there's a spare seat here. You had me going for a while, you and your little playmate. But now you're in. And you've got mates.
Yeah, I know. We're still not near in finding out about Helen.
Well, she should be out again soon.
Yeah, should be.
Smith.
I'll be with you in a minute. You wanted me?
Yes, I want you, Smith. This time you've gone too far.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play games with me. Making the wrong choice of company in here can have unfortunate results, and I don't like anyone trying to make a fool out of me.
No one's making a fool out of you.
You know what I mean. I would have thought you'd have more sense than to try and cross me.
Mrs. Powell, I understand how you feel.
Don't you patronise me. You couldn't begin to understand.
I know what it's like when something happens to your daughter.
That has nothing to do with this.
Yes, it has. But you're taking your hatred out on the woman who tried to help your kid.
Oh, what would you know?
Well, you have to take it on someone, I understand that. But the guy who hurt is dead. And so you're taking it out on her.
You're being insolent, Smith.
Don't you quote regulations to me. You lost the right to do that when you started setting Carol up for things she didn't do. To try and punish us and turn the woman against her.
Okay, you can consider yourself on a charge.
Fair enough. I'll be very happy to repeat everything I've just said in front of the governor.
Yeah, well, all I want to do is get out of here before Laurie finds out. It's the only thing that matters.
Yeah, well, the chances would have been better before Basher Burns had her way. But it won't hurt for the cops to have a second look.
Well, that's what we were saying.
Mail call. Cavelli. Gaffney.
Good old Auntie Gwen. Never misses.